in this video, we're gonna be taking your questions here live, or maybe you're here on the replay, all about how to get more views, more subscribers, and growth on your YouTube channel in 2019. But hey, if you're new here, my name is Sean Cannell. I'm the co-founder of Video Influencers, and I'm here with Benji Travis. Benji, what is Video Influencers all about?
Well, welcome to our channel where we're helping build your influence income impact with online videos. We want to help you with your channels. Get more views on your videos. Get you more subscribers to get a following, because we know that this is the best platform for online video. And Sean and I, we've got 20 years of combined experience, but better than that, we've interviewed 100 plus other YouTubers, content creators, entrepreneurs, business people on how to crush it here. So consider subscribing, hit that like button, and I'm excited to get into the very first question. Sean, did you want me to just go ahead and tackle that right now?
Crush it.
Yeah. So Mark's Adventures asked, how do you balance YouTube, family, and health? What a great question. And I believe that the way I balance this is knowing that all three of those is really important. And what I mean is this: obviously family is important, and obviously health is important. But YouTube, for us as YouTubers or content creators or business people utilizing this platform, like maybe as a marketing tool, it's also important. You know, making money and providing for your family is key. You know, having enough funds to be able to afford healthy food and to be able to get a gym membership, all those kind of things. So what I do every single day is ask myself, where have I not been investing a lot of time in this? And so every single day I give a little bit to each place. And being very purposeful in that, I wake up in the morning asking myself that, and then I go to sleep at night asking myself, did I do those three things, you know? And there's a number of other things, but what I love about this is really honestly, when it comes to my life, it's all about family, it's about helping others, and it's about following my passion. So for me, just like your question, Mark, about YouTube, family, and health. And so at the end of the day, a practical tip here is grab a schedule like this at the beginning of the week and write down what is important to you to accomplish that week. And every single day, what I do is I have mine right here. I have a little sticky note right here, and I write down the things I want to do, and I make sure that I'm tackling those things that are important to me. Sean, I don't know about you, but that's what I do.
Yeah, no, I agree with all of that, and that was a great answer. Brady asks, can you show us some examples of routines or your suggested routines? And a couple, I think one that I would recommend everyone in the community watch here is, if you haven't ever checked out our YouTube checklist video, it's all about like how we batch videos. And that is a routine. So put this on your to watch list. And it's called How to Make Videos That Get Views. It's a complete checklist. And if you've never seen this one, Benji and I actually go through kind of a batch day. Now this is, you know, we have a team now and some different things, but this is exactly what we would do. We'd have a mini fridge full of LaCroix to stay hydrated. Cause like, you know, how else are you gonna stay hydrated on your thing, right? But it's all about having a routine. So I'd say how you create your videos, that'd be one. I think other routines is, as Benji mentioned, just life routines, because probably the biggest thing that's holding a lot of us as creators back is all the other demands of life. You need to get disciplined maybe in your time management, your homework, your family things, those types of things, to buy yourself some margin. You need some time to work on your side hustle and to work on your YouTube channel. I mean, Benji and I can of course relate throughout the years. He's done real estate. I worked at Red Robin serving fries and burgers for 10 years.
We just ate there. We just ate there, by the way, though.
Man, I love it, man. Red Robin is.
Yes. 10 years. Sean was working there for 10 years, you guys, and hustling while, and I didn't even know this. This is a funny story. Sorry, I'm taking over, but I have to tell this, Sean. We were eating at this Red Robin, and I was thinking, you know, all the years that I knew you, that you were working with me, I had no clue you were working at Red Robin on top of it. So Sean was living a life where he was giving as much effort out to his YouTube channel and his business, supporting other creators like myself, in a way where you would never think he'd have time for a day job. But that was your day job, wasn't it, Sean?
That's right. And so It was a matter of just getting organized in the other areas. Mm-hmm. And I would encourage, you know, when you're developing these habits, you know, study, read on them, work on them. They're like a muscle and they grow over time. And like, kind of like my biceps are nowhere near the size of Benji because I don't freaking work out, man. All I do is run. And I haven't been developing the muscle. The same is true about the YouTube habits though. Batching your videos, mm-hmm. consistently shooting videos, planning out videos, designing thumbnails, optimizing your description. You might feel, oh, I don't know, the title, the thumbnails, the tags, it's frustrating. But every time you do it a little bit, you get better at it as you go. So batch mm-hmm. videos, Brady, life routines, and then routines and maybe how you come up with video ideas and a lot of those other things. And so I recommend one of the biggest things we'd encourage is just continue to work on your own routine. Because I've seen a thing that blocks when you try to fit in someone else's shoes, it doesn't fit, man. It was like when David was trying to wear heavier Saul's armor, like when he's gonna fight Goliath, he's like, yo, I don't fit in this, man. I have a sling and a stone. That's how I'm gonna take down this giant. Finding out your own rhythms, your own routines. When are you most effective? Early morning? Tell us in the comments right now. Or late at night? Or middle of the day? Are you building your day around the time when you're most creative, when you have the best energy to be on camera? And it's hard. Like, you might be freaking exhausted after work and you gotta crush some Red Bulls, but figure out yourself, self-awareness, and let's hit the next question, Benji.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So Terrible Decision says, how often do you guys do content brainstorming sessions? So just on a broad level, because Sean and I have multiple channels, for me, it's annually and weekly. And let me explain. Every single year, I challenge myself to come up with 52 video ideas for the whole year. So I have at least one video idea for every single week that's gonna be coming up in the next 12 months. But the reason I also do a brainstorming session at the beginning of the week, because you know there's always ideas that come to you based on your observation of what people are saying. Or maybe there's a trendy thing going on social media that you could jump on and integrate into your type of content. So I think this is a macro and a micro. It's kind of like going broad and what's generally what I'm passionate about, what my channel is all about, that I'm going to be, you know, feeding from in terms of my 52 video ideas. And on a weekly basis, I'm observing my results. I'm reading the comments and I'm adjusting my strategy. So that is what I do. And that is kind of like how much we brainstorm ideas. And so honestly, even beyond that, you know, once in a while, I just get a great idea and I make sure that 52 video idea is a shortcut on my phone and I add it right away. I do not stop. In fact, I've been doing this literally from the very beginning. I don't know why I'm thinking about this, but I remember hanging out in the Philippines with Judy where there was no internet and I had this idea and I wrote it on a piece of paper because that's all I had. There was no internet there. And I kept that piece of paper. I was like, I'm not gonna lose this thing. I put it in my pocket, it's all folded up. And then when I finally got back home, or really when I got back to the internet, I wrote those into my document. So I think this is a great question because if you've always got ideas somewhere you can go to during those moments where you're lacking inspiration, you can go to my 52 video ideas is much longer now and get inspiration.
Yeah, I love that. And for me, it just depends. Some seasons I keep Google Docs. Inspiration hits me if I'm at a conference or if I'm in public or I just get it. So I wanna encourage you, rather than doing a brainstorming session, always be open to like letting a YouTube idea, like when I make a good video idea, like you might be, I live here in Vegas and I could be at a restaurant and I could, you know, be in a conversation and someone's maybe talking about their mindset related to like, oh, you know, YouTube is kind of like this. I'm like, oh, that's a video idea. So like in your phone, Evernote, a note doc, always be capturing ideas. That's one tip. And then I agree with Benji, we sometimes brainstorm together. And we'll link up some resources because we have some videos about how to come up with video ideas. Next question, DIY Ashley, and we have a super chat, shout out to 9to5 No More. Thank you so much for the support. And we may be able to get some channel reviews at the end here. How do you narrow down your channel? I'm starting DIY, but I have a wide area I wanna cover. Should I try to focus on one thing? Well, a couple things. Number one, we actually wanna mention, just give a shout out to our friend Matt Gielens launched a new channel. Little Monster is now putting out some videos and he's putting out some great videos and they study deep in the YouTube analytics. So if you haven't checked out that channel, check it out, Little Monster Co. And they study deep in the analytics. And one of the things, he's made some bold statements, but we're seeing this across YouTube. Variety channels now are struggling more than ever before. Like, mm-hmm. and that the conclusion basically is this, is that your channel should have one value proposition and one, that, and then the whole channel should be aligned with that. And he actually, if you want to check out a really great video, he did a coaching session for an hour with Evan Carmichael. And he mentioned basically, Evan said, I'm putting up three different types of videos on his channel. And his conclusion was like, you kind of need three channels, but you shouldn't have three channels because that's a lot of focus. Well, he has a team, so you could. So here's the point. Man, focus is power. And I know that all of us here, we struggle, right? We're like, oh, I got 40 ideas. I want to do 100 things. And you can sometimes put variety underneath a singular value proposition. But here's the biggest thing you want to know, Ashley. If someone subscribed to your channel because you were going to show them how to organize their closet and organize their kitchen mm-hmm. and organize their whole house and declutter their house, that's a good, every video is about decluttering. If you started to upload videos about motherhood or not even DIY, like home decor, the declutter people might be like, dude, I just don't want to make the home decor. I want mm-hmm, to mm-hmm. just watch the declutter stuff. Now, it becomes your decision to potentially upload two different types of content. But in studying and what Matt Gielen has discovered, the problem with the algorithm right now is if you put out one video that the majority of your subscribers are like, nah, I'm not interested in that. It's not that it's a bad video. It's not why I subscribed in the first place. They skip mm-hmm. over it, it gets pushed down, and every upload now is actually kind of building your channel authority in real time. Years ago, videos just kind of had, they're almost like were islands and they could succeed, and that's still true, but it's just becoming more important than ever before, which is honestly not something entirely new. It's about having a clear vision, a clear path,
yeah.
a clear value proposition, clear goals, a clear reason why people should subscribe, what value are they gonna get in return, and think about this, when they click subscribe, you actually, the reason they're gonna come back is for predictable content. Mm-hmm. You actually mm-hmm. wanna become you wanna become predictably unpredictable, meaning they know what to expect from you, but it's still fresh. I'm not saying that's easy, but man, alignment is so powerful. So you said, should I try and focus on one thing? You kinda should try and focus on one value proposition, one promise, one reason people subscribe and keep following up on that. And the last thing I'll say is, yeah, no, that's probably what I'll say.
Yeah, yeah. And let me chime in here, Sean, because it's a great question, Ashley. And it's a great question because there's a lot of you who are watching this that probably have the same question. And one tip I would give, say you have a niche, but maybe you have like three different topics you want to cover and you still have to boil it down. One of the easiest ways to kind of figure out where you want to start and commit to long term is ask yourself, where do I have the most fun? What topic, what niche just makes me want to get out of bed and just like shout to the world, I'm going to make a video about this and I'm going to have so much fun doing it. And if literally I only got one view, that's okay because I just love this. That's a great place to start. When you have that kind of enthusiasm and you have that kind of energy and passion about something, typically people that are also interested in that topic or looking for those type of niche videos want to watch a creator like that. I can tell you when Sean and I are having fun creating videos, those videos tend to do a lot better. And so, you know, typically Sean and I are always having fun, but there's certain days we're just like, dude, this is going to crush. This is amazing. This is a topic that's going to help people. And you know, you found from like the last few months of our experiences and observations, this is going to be so valuable. And when we have that energy and we put on that camera, man, and I'll tell you, you know, Sean and I, we're in our fifth year of video influencers. If we didn't have that kind of energy or a passion about helping you guys get more views, get more subscribers, build your influence, income, impact with online videos, it wouldn't have lasted very long. And I'd argue the chemistry between our niche content type and our heart is kind of what made this channel successful. So at the end of the day, if you're watching this and you're struggling, like, what do I pursue? Because I've got two different things that are kind of competing. And if you can't combine them and you have to pick one, pick the one that you have the most fun pursuing? So we're going to get to the next question, which is Jam Family. But before that, hit like if you guys are loving these Q&As, because we don't do them very often. We would like to do more of them. Comment below what your questions are, because even if we don't get to it right now, we'll answer them after the live broadcast. And make sure you're subscribed if you haven't subscribed already. So next question is from Jam Family, Deval, which is, what do you do when you experience a plateau stage? You've got to do two things. Number one, you got to really dive into your analytics. You got to dive into your videos and the results and figure out, like, why am I hitting this plateau, right? What kind of adjustments can I make? What are the new techniques? What are the new strategies I can implement into my content? And secondly, you just got to work harder and smarter. But you gotta work harder. I'll tell you, we've hit plenty of plateaus in our whole journey here on this platform. And what's interesting is you're not the only person hitting a plateau. There's many, many others. In fact, maybe the plateau isn't of your doing. Maybe there's an algorithm change, or maybe that content isn't as popular anymore. When you dig deeper, you work harder, and you level up your hustle, just things start popping out. Like answers and solutions and strategies. And that is all going to come about. It's going to rise. It's going to be seen on the horizon when you work that much harder. But go back to the basics. That's why I say, hey, dig into your analytics. Observe the results. Really be paying attention, because maybe the reason you're hitting a plateau is because you got comfortable. Maybe you're not doing the best practices. You're not pursuing the principles. Maybe you don't have habits. Sean and I, if you haven't, go check out that video. We'll either put it in the info box or it'll probably show up somewhere. We just talked about the 7 habits of highly successful YouTubers. Maybe you've slept on some of those habits. So a plateau is definitely a reason to wake up and be like, what the heck is happening? And then adjust. So that was a lot. But Sean, any other questions here?
I love it. Yeah, we'll take some more questions. You know, a lot of questions have been coming in about getting started. And so definitely want to hit a couple of those, but just want to shout you out, 9to5. Thanks for being here. Havix, Midwest Man, Miss Melissa. We're live, Life Ladder. Hey, if you're here on the replay, thanks for being here. And as it pertains to all the questions about getting started, here's what we want to say. Number one, if you're broke, we have an entire library of free videos. And if you haven't watched the over 150 videos here on the channel, maybe it's 200 now, watch those. But our best advice for getting started that we would recommend is honestly, if you haven't gone through YouTube Secrets. And so you can get our book, YouTube Secrets. There's the ebook, is the cheapest way to get it. It's $4.99 right now. The price is gonna go up pretty soon. So grab it if you haven't grabbed it. For $4.99, you can get the book, you can get physical, and the audiobook's out now. So anything you want, Amazon's around the world. But here's the thing, you could get in for $4.99, and we've got this entire free bonuses. And for some of you, you haven't even gone through here yet, make sure to get these, because this action guide is gonna show you how to get started. You're gonna get a full advanced training video. We're gonna go deep in the 7 C's. You're gonna get an action guide that's gonna help you get massive clarity on your niche, on who you're serving, on your channel, on your strategy. And to get in, all you have to do is get any copy of YouTube Secrets, and then we wanna give you all of those, all of that content. And going through that is really to lay a good foundation. You know, for the price of half a Happy Meal at McDonald's, we wanna lay a foundation, get you clarity, get you, you know, figuring out what you're doing on YouTube. Link in the description below that. All the info is at tubesecretsbook.com. And that's just to serve you, help you, give you that free PDF action guide to get clarity. And then we're gonna do a strategy call a little bit later on that as well this week. So join us live this coming Saturday. Depending on when you're watching this, maximalist minibus, how do you balance self-reflection with trying to please an audience, especially when just starting out? Man, it's a good question, because if you just follow your own heart and do just what you wanna do, it doesn't mean that anyone's gonna care. And so what's the balance of the practicality of your YouTube channel as well as your personal passion? And there's a video we'll link up where we teach on the 3 things. If you want some clarity on how to know what you should do YouTube about, it's the intersection of your passion, your proficiency, and profit, meaning the market. So maximalist minibus and knowing your channel, you're in a perfect thing, because your passion is nomad, you know, you know, redoing a bus, hitting the roads, living a nomadic lifestyle, working on the road. So you're passionate about that. Then you say, are you proficient at it? Well, I know you are because you're doing the stuff. You're living it. Like, you're actually doing it. You've learned the lessons. You've made the mistakes. And can it be profitable? Well, it's the audience, meaning, is there a market for people who want to learn how to live the nomadic lifestyle, how to rebuild a school bus and hit the road? All of the above is true. So what I would say is you want to have, it's a mix of both. You're already in a niche you're passionate about. I think the problem would be if I'm capable personally of doing a lot of things, but it doesn't mean they're like right in my gray zone. So I'm trying to find, it's a mix. Does that make sense? It's a mix of those three things. What am I passionate about following my heart? Like Benji doing cooking and like Judy being passionate about being a mom, his wife, and like Heather on our, she's passionate about, she's on my team here in Vegas. She does Think Media stuff, but she also does a homeschool channel. So it's that passion, but you're also proficient at it. Benji, I don't think you've ever gone to cooking school, have you?
Nope.
Benji never went to cooking school, but dude is a legend. Why? Because he's clocked the hours.
Legend.
So his Benji Man Food TV, YouTube channel is all about cook. So he's got the passion. He's got the proficiency. How old is the oldest now, Benji?
Six.
Six. I mean, Judy became a mom. Now she's been doing it for 6 years. So it's just like the motherhood. I mean, she's living it. Like the pain, the ups, the downs. So passion, but also what have you clocked some time in? And then identifying what market you can serve. The cool thing is, man, the internet is so broad that anything can actually be turned into profit. You know, years ago, a book changed our life called Crush It by Gary Vaynerchuk. And it was how to turn your passion into profit. And, you know, we're not going to go deep into some of those monetization strategies, but that's something we've covered heavily here as well. So those are a few tips for you. Next question, Benji.
Yeah, and just one more thing I want to add to your maximalist is it's important to, you know, just decide you're going to commit and just know that you might not know the answer to that question to a year later. So I think what Sean said is very valuable. I mean, we put it into the book for a reason. However, you might not know, like, is that the right niche combination or self-reflection decisions or observations until a year into it. And that's why when we do channel audits, by the way, FYI, if you're going to ask for a channel audit and you haven't uploaded 100 videos, then I'm already going to tell you the first piece of advice is upload 100 videos, right? You need that experience and you need that longevity to be able to have results you can really observe and make the proper decisions and adjustments. But going to the next one, next question. Cobes Castle says, I have a question. What if you're a YouTube animator and you can't produce videos daily or weekly? Well, great question. By the way, I just was talking to somebody that has one of the biggest animation channels on this platform, and they pump out videos all the time, but they don't do it themselves. But in the beginning, they uploaded a lot less. And so one thing I would suggest is in a niche like that, where you can't upload very much, focus on quality. Now, this is where Sean and I really differ, because Sean would definitely lean on the side of quality most times. I lean on the side of quantity. Obviously, different niches, different types of content, business models and goals would determine where you lean. But in your case, specifically with animation, and because honestly, the better the animation is, the more likely I would want to watch, or a kid might want to watch. I don't know who your audience is. So quality is the most important thing. And what I would do, and this is what I'm finding more and more, and Sean, I'd love to hear your thoughts on this, because we're talking about how YouTube is changing the algorithm, focus on different things. You know, I think everybody can take a break a little bit. When I say take a break, put on the brakes and focus way more on quality, because when you pump out a video that is just hitting every single note, every single piece of information, your animations are on point, the timing of your edits and the colors are perfect. When you create a video that is spectacular and amazing, those just tend to take off. And it might not be right away, but it'll stand the test of time and it'll create evergreen views for you. And what evergreen views are, like you upload and usually the shelf life of a video typically is going to be like 1 to 2 weeks. It's going to get the most views. And then afterwards it kind of trickles on. But an evergreen video continuously gets views. Views while you snooze, as Sean and I would say. So I'd say lean on quality. Focus on creating the best animation possible. And my second piece of advice is consider getting people to help you, whatever that means. If you have to hustle more at your work or you have a side business to make some money and hire like a part-time animator or somebody you can outsource your graphics to, that's what I'd say.
I love it. And you know, Benji, I totally agree. In 2019, I am all about quality over quantity, and only quantity if you can keep the quality high. What I would encourage everybody, and I saw some feedback from some people saying, you know, we try to get better with every upload. Don't feel intimidated if, you know, we say keep the quality high. You're like, well, I'm just learning cameras. I'm just learning editing. I'm just learning. You got to start where you are. Like Benji mentioned, get your first 100 videos posted, but think about leveling up your quality more and more. And one of the biggest pieces of advice I would give to a lot of people in our community and just in our macro online community is I see a lot of people uploading sometimes daily. And I think actually your channel would go, if you actually took all the energy that you're putting into like 7 videos and put it into like 1 to 3, I think it would be a better strategy for you. Personal opinion. Because by trying to put out that volume, it sometimes dilutes the message. And there's been some studying of channels that, again, there's variables to this. You can't really make definitive statements, but that 3 is the kind of new, like 3 is the new sweet spot of uploads in the week that are higher quality. And that's from people who study a lot of channels and a lot of videos. It depends on the niche. It depends what you're doing, you know, if you're streaming, whatever else. But anyways, quality over quantity, I think, is a huge one. Benji, I want to jump in, and we can only do one of these. So if there's any more super chats, we can't do more channel reviews. But yep. If you want to just get a question prioritized towards the end here. But thank you, 9to5, for the super chat earlier. And I just wanted to give a quick kind of channel review here. I think this could add value to everybody. You know, first of all, Benji, I'd love your thoughts. It took me a while to understand what the channel was about, but it's pretty good because I had to kind of say like, okay, 9to5, cross it out. Okay. So that means, okay, 9to5, no more. Okay. Don't be a slave to the night. So once I was adding it up, that was my thought process looking at that creative. But hey, everybody watching, remember this. If you confuse, you lose. If I land on your YouTube channel or your Instagram or your Twitter profile or your LinkedIn, it doesn't matter. And I'm confused in less, if it doesn't make sense in a few seconds, I'm gone and you lose. Period. Because it's gotta make sense. Now, I think this is pretty strong, but clarity is king, even over, I believe, creativity. Because people are wondering, what's this all about? Now, I'm feeling pretty strong because the general gist is don't be a slave to the 9to5 grind. But what are you, is this weekly? I'd love to see on the cover, weekly training videos or weekly educational videos. Like what exactly am I gonna learn here? We could go over to the about page. Now I'm getting some stuff, so let's read this. My name's Daniel. Thank you for checking out 9to5 No More. It's a channel dedicated to helping you break through from the grind, okay? I believe that you're meant to. I like that you got that in there. Here on this channel, you're gonna show you the best tips and tricks and tools. I like those. So like tips, tricks, and tools for making money online. Now, I hope you have a tagline. We're probably not gonna listen to a video, but then you wanna educate in each video that. I love that. And then another thing I was just curious rhetorically, I noticed on your first video here, it's doing amazing. So, I mean, for your first upload, really good views, good engagement here. People already commenting. This makes me think you maybe had an audience somewhere else and you sent some traffic, which is a great idea and a great tip for everybody watching. Leverage social media to build your YouTube channel when you're early stage. And, you know, the next thing I would say is I love that you sent this video in to us, you know, or this channel. But like your first upload started a week ago. Now, maybe you have some older private videos or something. But first thing I would probably say is we're already giving you a few tips here, but remember this, like Benji said, you just need to pump out some content. Like for everybody watching, like get to your first 10 to 30 to 100 videos. I know it sounds like a lot, but probably your first at least 10 to 30. And then you could start diving in analytics and looking back over what you've done so far. You already have a few videos we can audit to say what's working. But like, dude, you can't tell what's working in a week. Sometimes it's hard to tell if it's working over a few months. So my point is,
hey, Sean.
Yeah.
Go ahead. Sorry. Yeah, you can. Why don't you finish and then put it back on there because I have a couple things I want to
mention. Okay, perfect. Yeah. So, anyways, yeah, just keep pumping out more more quality. But I love where you're starting. Loving the about page because the clarity of the channel is really clear to me. So I really think in this case, small tweaks will lead to giant peaks. But go ahead, Benji, dive in.
Yeah, you know, and I'm surprised Sean didn't mention it because he is the king of thumbnails. If I look at all those videos, that first thumbnail is maybe the best one, and I'll tell you why. Number one, the emotion, it matches the text in there, and it matches the title, right? And the yellow really stands out against the darker gray color. It's actually a great like combination. Then you go into your other videos and you make a few mistakes here, okay? You need to hear this. The hear this kind of gets lost against that butterfly thing, right? Secondly, you know, you are a handsome guy. I love the beard. You're looking clear, but the emphasis should not be on you. It should be on the title and that supporting text, because if that text isn't legible, then it's just going to be lost. And people are just going to look at it and say, oh, handsome guy, but it's not what I'm looking for, whatever, right? So I think that one thing that I tell, you know, Chris, nice Chris on our team, he makes almost all of our thumbnails when we go live. And obviously Sean does too. But when I'm critiquing him, I always say, hey, and Sean, you can put it back on me if you want. You know, this is a thing, almost everybody can relate to this, whether you use a free online program to edit thumbnails or you're using, Adobe Photoshop, whatever. You have this huge screen. I have this huge monitor in front of me, and Adobe Photoshop makes my thumbnails look awesome, but they show up on this. Right? So you might think your thumbnail looks amazing on your screen, but you need to test it on your phone. And so that's something if you don't like understand that, this is the thing. It's not like you're oblivious to it. If you are uploading videos, you probably watch YouTube videos and you're affected by the thumbnail. And so the thumbnail being small, if the text is mixed up into the background because the colors are kind of making each other disappear, or maybe it's too small or it just doesn't line up, then, you know, that's my one suggestion, because I have a feeling, Sean, that first video, part of the success is literally the thumbnail and title combination. So, you know, when we do channel audits, sometimes I get tired because I tell you the guys the same thing. But if you make the greatest video of all time, but your thumbnail just doesn't represent it, or your title isn't lined up with that content, YouTube's gonna have a hard time figuring out. Don't get me wrong, the algorithm being artificial intelligence, it's doing a lot better to surface content regardless of all those kind of things. But if you're competing against somebody else with a similar content, same quality, your thumbnail and title is what's gonna make the difference.
I agree. So thank you so much for that super chat. Hope that got value. We have like one or two more questions here, but a couple quick announcements of some things that will add value. We are excited. The audiobook of YouTube Secrets is out now. And so super excited about that. And let us know in the comments, do you prefer physical books or audiobooks? We'd love to hear from you. Grab that and whatever version, all the versions are out and they should be out at all the Amazons around the world. So if you're in Australia or India, you could go to your local Amazon and you should be able to get a copy of YouTube Secrets at all of those. Secondly, make sure to get the bonuses. Like so many in our community maybe haven't heard about this yet. We've got a free PDF download. That's, by the way, that will walk you through step-by-step to give you crystal clear clarity on growing your YouTube channel, figuring out kind of some of the things we talked about, figuring out your branding, your messaging, and kind of like a checklist, as well as a training that goes along with it. And you can grab that at tubesecretsbook.com. It's over, you know, again, whether the ebook or the physical book or the audiobook is all you got to do. And then you can claim your bonuses and all the details are there. And then also we are giving away a couple one-on-one coaching sessions. And we talk about that in the beginning of the book. All you have to do is share about YouTube Secrets. If you got a book, it's on your phone, the Audible, be creative, make a video, upload a YouTube review, but make sure to use the hashtag YouTube Secrets. Over the next couple of weeks, our team's gonna be picking out people using the hashtag randomly, and then we'll reach out to you so we can give you a personalized Q&A as well as channel review. And we're gonna be doing those over on the Video Influencers Facebook page, kind of like live so other people can learn from them. And it's gonna be a lot of fun. And hey, if you're getting value out of this Q&A and you want us to do some more Q&As, save the date. This coming Saturday, we've got a training coming up live together. And so smash like, we appreciate it. Thanks so much for being here. I'm gonna hit this one tip for the super chat. Thank you, Next Gen Vlogs, and it's this for the super chat. And then Benji, take that last question. And so Next Gen Vlogs, I just wanna tell you this. I just look at your channel. Thanks for the super chat. You're really early. I see that your oldest upload's 4 months and it looks like you just started vlogging maybe like a month ago. And so my number one piece of advice is, first of all, without going deep into it, consume the training, because if you haven't watched, you know, some of the deeper content on YouTube Secrets or whatever it is, that'll help you. But I just want to encourage you to upload more videos. And as crazy as that sounds, I know you're looking for growth tips, but everybody in the influencers community, we learn by doing. Here on this channel, we're giving you strategies, we're giving you tips, we're bringing you experts, we're bringing you YouTubers. Take that information, but then also take massive action and deploy that information against your content, but upload massive content. And here's what I mean, Next Gen Vlogs. A lot of people don't know this about me because I've got my Think Media channel, I've got whatever, but you don't know that, like, I've got the Sean Cannell channel. I don't even know how many videos are on here, but 10 years ago, I'm uploading, I don't know where you find those, like whatever, maybe a couple hundred videos. And for a while I vlogged, and for a while I was doing weird Droid videos on my Droid phone, and I was uploading stuff. But here's my point. 6 years ago, I'm reviewing Spider-Man and I'm reviewing Shin Ramen and I'm like, whatever. I'm doing all kinds of stuff, but all of this was learning for me. So like, upload more videos. If you wanna be successful on YouTube, post videos on YouTube. A lot of people don't know that I did this channel with my friend Jeff for years. We uploaded like a couple hundred videos, and then there's of course Video Influencers, and even my production channel back in the day. Here's back when Benji and I, how we first met, if you haven't heard our story, we started working together on these collabs, and I started off with filming their engagement. This is a playlist of all the videos, some like 23 videos that at least, and there's a couple other brand deals and things that I help with, are all on here. What's the point? Dude, work that muscle, man. You know, I haven't been in the gym. I don't have the guns here, but I got the video freaking guns because I've uploaded some freaking videos. You know what I mean? Like, I've been lifting the iron of shooting, editing. Whoops, I forgot to turn my microphone on. Now I want to go stand in front of a bus. You know what I mean? Like, I just lost 2 hours. Like, whoops, I forgot to save in my editing software. Can you relate to me? You know what I mean? All of that stuff, like, embrace the process, enjoy the journey. Focus massively on your education and learning from experts, but focus massively on posting. So Next Gen, thanks for the super chat. I just wanna encourage you, keep trying, keep posting videos. And it seems basic, but like, that's where a lot of learning is gonna come as you study some of the strategies in the book and everywhere else.
Yeah, I can tell you the number one mistake you're gonna make is quit too early. I love that Sean just dived into it. I haven't seen that in so long. All those different channels, all those different videos, because obviously Sean is definitely one of the best, if not the best, YouTube expert on this platform. But it happened because he made a lot of failures and he had a lot of mistakes and he had a lot of learning experiences. So Next Gen, I dig where you're going. Now you just got to commit at least a year, 100 plus videos, observe, adjust. And you know, one tip is this, for everybody just getting started, especially if you're under 6 months, if you're doing everything or you feel like you're doing everything, you're not getting traction, one thing you can do is just really ask yourself, is this a video that other people would wanna watch? Or am I the only one that would wanna watch it? So ask people that will give you an honest opinion, that would give you constructive criticism and feedback that's actually valuable. Hey, is this a good video? If those people are saying, this is a great video, I don't know how, it's not getting more views, like, and they're for reals about it, just keep doing it. You just never know, because maybe you are missing some of the optimization techniques. But the last question, and then we're gonna call it a night, is from Santhis, and they ask, what is the percentage that we should be going for when it comes to watch time, which I think you mean audience retention, which is the percentage of your video that people should be watching. Now, obviously, you want people watch 100%, but if there was a number, I'd say like 70, 80% is what I look for. I look for a majority, but the real question is, wherever they drop off, what is going on in that video? because what you might find isn't like, because this thing, it's not enough just to see that number. It's like, oh, next time I'm going to push for 80 because this time I got 70%. You go to, and this is what's cool about the tool, and we don't have time to dive into it, but sometimes Sean and I, we show, you can go to your analytics, you can actually click on the part where there is a drop when it goes from, you know, like 70% and then no one watches, and you can see the actual clip that makes people jump out of your video and be like, what am I doing there that so many people are not interested in? And then drop that. Or maybe extend the stuff that's interesting. Because, you know, one thing that Sean and I, this is real talk, this is an observation we made, our outros, no one cared about them anymore. So we started shortening them. In fact, even my food videos, I'm like, you know, no one really even cares about the different playlists, right? Because so many of my videos are utility. People are searching for recipes, they find it, and they could care less about subscribing. So long outros don't really make sense for those type of videos, so we've dramatically shortened it. So yes, the percentage is important because it gives you a number, and that's what you're asking for, but what is key is observing what's in that drop. What is influencing people leaving your video? Because YouTube doesn't like that. All right, so Sean?
Man, if you're getting value, smash like. Thank you so much for being here. Hey, really big announcement, and that is just that this week, the YouTube Secrets audiobook is out, and a lot of you have already picked up the physical book or the ebook, and we just want you to know about these free bonuses. So tubesecretsbook.com, that is the big thing to know about, whether it's the audiobook, the physical book, or the ebook. That's how you can get access to a free action guide, a training video. That's like your next step. If you're like, what do I do next right now? Go claim those bonuses and watch, fill out that action, like fill it out, print it out maybe, and even plan on paper, or you can use the PDF to help you plan in a journal. But like, do the work. That's what we want to encourage you to do right now. Mm-hmm. Do the deep thinking. Go through that content because it's really going to help you. That's what we're like. Our mission, right, is to help you build your influence, income, and impact with online video. We don't need to do this channel. And I say that gently in the sense of Benji's got a full-time career with him and his wife vlogging, with his channel, with the empire they're building. I'm based here in Vegas. He's up in Seattle where I originally grew up. We're building Think Media and we're covering tech and doing other social media strategy. So we've got these other projects, but this is a passion project that it's about you. This is a passion project that is about helping you discover the life-changing power of online video, because online video changed our lives. You've heard both of us, over 20 years of experience between both of us years ago as these small town kids growing up in this small town in the Pacific Northwest, you know, out in the woods away from downtown Seattle.
Sounds like
right?
An alternative and, song.
Yeah, just growing up, building this thing. We saw that this YouTube thing, you know, has completely revolutionized our life. And now we're talking to you and pumping out content. And it's been a journey. And there's been ups and there's been downs. But online video is changing the world. It's changing businesses. Yeah. It's changing nonprofits. And it has the potential to change your life, no matter what it is you want to build, what it is you want to do. And we're so passionate about this moment in history for going all in, for learning the strategies, learning the tips, posting the videos, getting punched in the face with discouragement and the ups and downs, but not quitting, because literally our kids and our grandkids are gonna be like, what? You lived through the era when social media just got started? You lived through the era? Look, even if YouTube is now like a teenager, YouTube's coming up on like, you know, 15-year-old or whatever it is, it's still young, man. It's still a teenager. Hasn't left the house yet. Can't drive legally yet, you know, or whatever. And so go all in and maximize this moment in history. Mm-hmm. And we're here to help you. And let us know how we can. You know, post questions in the comments. And we're trying to pump out as much content and bring you as many experts as possible. So let us know how we can help. But that's what this channel is all about, is helping you win. Benji.
Yeah. And the last thing I'll leave you with, and I love that. Basically, you stole what I was going to say, Sean, because I'm not kidding. I was going to be like, you know, Sean and I, we don't have to do this channel. And honestly, our business and financially, you know, our life wouldn't be affected if this was something that we both kind of opt out of or put on hold or whatever. But that's the point we're trying to make. We love helping you realize the significance of YouTube. We love helping you get more views and subscribers, because ultimately we know what it will lead to, which is a life of purpose, success, money, right? We've met many, and not just us, like we've met people that have made millions of dollars from this platform. There's no other video website or app that even compares to YouTube. And if there is one thing, Sean, I bet you probably, I mean, we already were like aggressive, but if there is one thing I could tell myself in 2010, when I first started my personal channel, I was already helping Judy for a couple of years with her other channel. If I could tell myself, you need to upload double the videos. You need to get rid of all your other activities, because literally the ROI on creating more videos, this is one of the benefits of Sean uploading so many videos, because he really figured out the algorithm and figured out where like the open opportunities are, is you are just gonna learn so much so that when the time is right, you can capitalize on it. And so I have no regrets. In fact, one of the reasons I'm doing this is because YouTube has been amazing to our family. We live a life, in fact, tomorrow I'm getting on a plane. I'm going to New York City for something very special. I can't say what it is, but it's because of YouTube, right? And then the week after that, again, I'm going to something else, to a whole nother country, being flown out because of what we do as YouTubers. And so this lifestyle isn't something I could have ever dreamed of, but it is because of YouTube. It is because of being a YouTuber. And so our passion behind this, why we wrote a book, which even like people say, why would you write a book if you're already putting out videos? We're so passionate about what we do here that we don't just want to connect with you who are subscribed to this channel and watch this video. We want to connect with people who aren't on the platform. And so just know, if I could be that person 10 years from now that's talking to you, start uploading. Start uploading more, higher quality content, and hustle as much as you can. Find the small pieces of time to create content and engage with people, because you will not regret it. What you will regret is sleeping on this opportunity.
100%. Question of the day, influencers, is what is your question? And do us a favor, if you're here live, come back and post it in the real comments, because we wish we could have got some more questions. But what we'll do on this video is we'll look through some of the questions to see about future video ideas and topics we can cover. So after it's over, the real questions appear. Post your question there. We just wanna say we're so grateful for you that you'd invest some of your time with us hanging out here, whether live or on the replay. Really, if you got value today or you've gotten value from this channel, can you smash the like button? And we want to just remind you that this channel is here to help, and we are super, super grateful for you. Benji, good to go?
Good to go. That's up.
Benji laid back. All right. So yeah, thanks again, influencers, for being here. And as a reminder, subscribe. If you're not subscribed, if you want to check out, man, my slides are messed up. I'm trying to do this weird end card that nobody will even be here for. All right. Hey, click subscribe. Check out those videos on the screen. This channel is all about helping you build your influence, income, and impact. We love you guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.